Now, we're going to switch lanes for just a second and talk about Delphi, Indiana, and Richard Allen. For you guys that do not know what the case is, two beautiful young girls were brutally murdered underneath the Monon High Bridge, I believe it's called, in Delphi, Indiana. This man right here, 6 years later, Richard Allen, was arrested for the crime. And the only evidence that they seem to have is a bullet casing that was in the area where the bodies were found. By the way, they weren't shot. So let that sink in. There's a bullet casing in the area where Richard Allen typically goes to walk on the bridge, but these kids wasn't shot. So let that sink in. I'm not a big believer that Richard Allen did it, much like I'm not a big believer in the Koberger thing. I know a lot of you guys do feel like he did it, but I want you to look at this man. He's being tortured. He's being starved. And I know exactly where he's at because I've been there too. I'm JB Gunner. This is Crime Time. Let's do it. Bring it back. What's going on, everybody? As you guys know, I'm JB Gunner, and this is Crime Time. First and foremost, before we get into the story, I want to say thank you to all the people that support this channel, regardless of the method you choose, whether it's Cash App, Patreon, Venmo, PayPal. Truth is, guys, I couldn't do this each and every day as often as I do if it was not for you, the Gun Squad. So thank you guys so much. Recently lost pretty big sponsors, so you guys are definitely what keeps this thing moving. If my content is valuable to you, feel free to hit the links down below. Show some love, support the channel. I do want to give a special shout out just real quick while I'm here. You know what? I may wait to the live stream later to do it. But while you're down there, also feel free to check out some of my other content, my news channel, my politics channel, which currently is down for 7 days, my gaming channel. You can't be a snowflake and go over there, though. Let's just call it what it is. You guys get your feelings hurt. But let me give a shout out to Acre Commercial Realty. Thank you so much. Appreciate you very much for your support. All right, so let's go ahead and get this thing going. Richard Allen, definitely a guy that I don't believe they have any evidence on. But he, about 5 months ago, I believe, was incarcerated for this homicide. Delphi murderer suspect Richard Allen. Lawyers say he's been treated like a prisoner of war in cold concrete cell no bigger than a dog kennel, as they asked for him to be moved to county jail. For you guys that do not know, I believe Richard Allen is in, I believe they are actually housing Richard Allen in a place. I'm going to read the article and we're going to see. I believe Richard Allen is currently being housed in Westville State Penitentiary. Now, I've actually been to Westville State Penitentiary, believe it or not. Indiana is one of the areas that Indianapolis in that region I grew up in when I left Chicago before I moved down to the South. So I know the general region that he is in, unless they've moved him facilities. Last time I heard like the phone call about Richard Allen, that's where he was, is Westville State Penitentiary. And it's not a happy place at all. The way this penitentiary is, it is horrible. I'm talking about bugs in your food, just a horrible, horrible facility. And a lot of you guys may think that's okay, but let's be real, it's not. It's disgusting. Allen was charged in October on 2 counts of murder for slaying teenage girls. Attorneys say he sleeps on a pad on the floor and is rarely let out. They're arguing that the conditions are ruining his health and slowing his defense. And you can clearly see it when you look at his pictures, by the way. You can clearly see, like, look at this man over here. Now look at this man over here. Clearly, in 5 months, look at what has happened to Richard Allen. Richard Allen was just fat, over out of shape, probably a beer drinker over here, right? Me and him have a lot in common. This Richard Allen looks like he has AIDS. Let's just call it, like, you can clearly see that his health is taking a hit. Now, I understand a lot of you people, especially that follow true crime, you don't understand the concept of innocent till proven guilty. There is no way in fuck that you can look at Richard Allen's picture right here beside me and think this is okay. He has not been found guilty. And to be perfectly honest, there's not even enough evidence at this point for you to really think he was guilty. Because the dude walking the bridge could have been a lot of different people. I'm just saying. So anyway, let's go ahead and go on back to this. In fact, let's go ahead and just check out the story like this. Coming out of Fox 59, let's
News
listen.
Now at 4, the attorneys representing Richard Allen, the man accused of killing two young girls in Delphi in 2017, claim he's being held in inhumane conditions. And
look at him. That's just a couple months ago. That image right there. And now he looks like this motherfucker's got cancer.
Let him move to a more hospitable and convenient county jail.
Now, Allen has been held at the state's Westville Correctional
Facility. I knew it was Westville Correctional. Yes. And Westville is a fucking dungeon. I'm telling you now, he's lucky he's in the hole, because Westville's the type of place that Richard Allen probably couldn't survive in. We called, you know, you'll fuck around and end up in what we call a gladiator block. I enjoyed being in the gladiator block because I like to fight. Richard Allen, though, I'm going to be perfectly honest, just taking a look at him, he doesn't really seem like that type of fella. You can clearly see he's not hitting the gym. He's not working out. There's none of that. Now, a lot of that, the lawyers say, is because the facility's stopping him. But Westville Penitentiary, let me say this, is probably the worst prison in Indiana. Now, keep in mind, Richard Allen has not been found guilty. He has no reason to be in Westville Penitentiary at all. The only prison in Indiana worse than Westville is a place called Michigan City, which is the big, big state prison, right? That's the big house in Indiana. So let's go ahead and get here. And no, I ain't never been to Michigan City.
Facility since last November. Fox 59's Russ McQuaid joins us now to explain
the
There is no
reason for a person to be housed in a DOC facility. I'm just making this clear. For you guys that don't understand the difference, the county jail is for people before they're found guilty. Prison is for people that have been found guilty. The fact that Richard Allen is in, I want you to understand, he's in a DOC facility right now and has not been found guilty at all. Not only is he in a DOC facility, but he's in a DOC facility whole. He's in isolation. You understand? He gets no pen, no paper, no phone calls, really, no nothing. That's the way the hole is, especially in prison. He probably doesn't even have much of a blanket. He clearly doesn't have the cot to lay on. He's literally on one of those green mattresses on the fucking cell of Westville Penitentiary where there's rats and everything. This is not a humane way to treat a motherfucker that has not been found guilty yet.
Attorney's emergency motion to modify Allen's confinement that was just filed today, Russ.
He's going
to
win this. He's going to win this.
This motion describes Allen's supposed mental and physical deterioration since he was arrested last fall, the challenge of his participation in his own defense, and the agency blocking the way for the accused killer to be jailed somewhere closer to home. This is the mugshot the Carroll County Sheriff released of Richard Allen last fall. He was arrested in October for the murders of Abby Williams and Libby German near the Monon High Bridge more than 6 years ago. This first photograph was from before, when Allen was arrested and put in prison, followed by his mugshot. This final one is
Look at this, man. You cannot look at that image and tell me, listen, for God's sakes, man. I understand you people believe the police, you believe everything, you believe Richard Allen's guilty. But come on, man. Here in America, you either believe in due process or you don't. You cannot look at this image and think this is fucking okay. This is not okay, man.
A recent photograph of Allen after spending 5+ months in a maximum security prison awaiting trial. Officials say it's for his own safekeeping.
And that's exactly right. Westville facility, Westville is a maximum security. What that means, in the state of Indiana, let me tell you how this works. There's level ones, which is basically like the farm. It's basically like for people that you can work outside, does that make sense? Nonviolent. Level two and up is Westville and things like that. Level two is for the more violent criminals, because a lot of my shit on my record was violence. I was always level two and up. And so level two and up is for the people. They try to keep those people separate. Like Miami Grissom Air Force Base in Indiana, that is the prison for like the child molesters, okay? And then we got Pendleton, Westville, Michigan City. That's for us violent folks. And then what you have is Plainfield, which is kind of a mixture of both. Then you have the farm, which is way down south, and motherfuckers, you literally, it's called farm for a reason. A lot of these level one facilities are basically just like camps. They're not really prison. Richard Allen is being held in not just any maximum security, one of the worst in the state. And once again, has not been found guilty. Hopefully that gives you a little bit of insight that I just happen to know because, well.
As he awaits trial and is presumed an innocent man, he's housed with some of Indiana's toughest inmates, and his attorneys say that he is being watched over by other offenders.
Yep.
In this motion filed this morning, Allen's attorneys say their client is being treated like, quote, a prisoner of war. That he suffers from depression, psychotic symptoms that are schizophrenic and delusional, and is being held in inhumane conditions.
Yep.
An attorney unaffiliated with the case who formerly sued the state to provide better living conditions inside Westville Correctional says it's likely Allen's judge doesn't even know what condition the defendant is in.
And that's exactly right. Because a lot of these judges, you have to understand, they're in completely other cities. Like, I lived in Indianapolis, which is like fucking 200 miles south of Westville, some shit like that, right? And so what I mean, the judges in it, like Indianapolis, ain't gonna know what's actually going on in the prisons all throughout the state. Because it's not like, what, for you guys that don't know, it's not like whatever city you get locked up in, that's the prison you go to. Prisons are in strategic locations all throughout the state. So like, you may get locked up in Indianapolis and be shipped off 300, 400 miles to a prison facility. Now, they try to typically put you where your family can visit you, but they really don't give a fuck. It's about the overcrowding, things like that. So for him to be all the way up there in Westville is insanity. And I guarantee you the judge has no clue. But I also will say this. Obviously, anybody involved in law enforcement and the legal system has to know. Everybody in Indiana knows Westville is probably the absolute worst prison in Indiana. Everybody in Indiana pretty much knows that.
I think he's going to be shocked at the conditions that this man is being held under and the effect that it's going to have on him. And if there's an obviously convenient and humane way to have him closer to the county that he's being prosecuted in and where his lawyers are, that makes the most sense to do right away.
The attorney's motion says Carroll County's prosecutor, Nicholas McLeland, has no objection to moving Allen to the Cass County Jail closer to Delphi.
That's the way it should
have been
to begin with.
Carroll County Sheriff objects.
What?
We've reached out to the sheriff and the prosecutor for comment. We haven't heard back from either of them.
How the fuck can the sheriff of a jail say, nah, we don't want him in our jail? Motherfucker, it's your job. What do you mean, no? What the fuck do you mean, no? He is an innocent man at this point in time. I hate the fucking legal system sometimes. This is not an option. You can't just send a man to prison. That's not the way this works. You have to be found guilty of a felony to go to prison. It's not the way, because listen, if you get convicted of like a misdemeanor, you usually do your time in the county jail. The reason for that is because misdemeanors have like a maximum of 1 year. Most people that are either guilty of misdemeanors or have a small amount of time, you just do your time in like the county. It's just kind of the way it works. I'm not saying you can't go to jail with prison with a misdemeanor, but I don't think it's likely. I've never seen it.
But the Indiana Department of Correction did say it couldn't comment because of a judge's gag order. In the studio, Russ McQuaid, Fox 59 News.
Gag order. Ain't that a bitch? So, for you guys that do not know, Allen was charged in October with two counts of this murder. His attorneys filed the only thing you need to see is this. That's it. That's all you need to see to understand what's going on here. Now, obviously, I'm going to ask you guys what you guys think of this. I'm personally tired of this shit. I'm tired of all of the people that are not treating these people as if they're innocent until proven guilty. We either believe in this shit or we don't. Richard Allen, in my opinion, is being tortured. He's literally being tortured. They said they add that he is being treated worse than already convicted criminals who can at very least have visits with their family. He's in isolation. He's deprived of his constitutional right to defend in his case. They say that he has gone from being polite and in good humor to an inability to communicate with his lawyers. Simply put, this version of Richard Allen was a very different version than counsel for Richard, Mr. Allen, had interacted with over the past 5 months. They say it's like a prisoner of war. He doesn't get outside rec time. He doesn't get time with his family. He doesn't get visits from his wife. And I understand the murder of Libby and Abby is horrible, but we don't know that he did it. That's my point. And I'm tired of this fucking crucifixion these people get just because you guys get so mentally wrapped up in the case. Listen, over the last 6 years, we've thought it was a million different people. Is it possible that they're wrong about Richard Allen? I haven't seen any real evidence yet. What do you guys think? Do you think Richard Allen did it? And do you think he deserves this? Do you believe in innocent until proven guilty? Do you believe he should be treated like a prisoner of war? Let me know in the comment section. Guys, if you like what I do here and you want to support the channel, feel free to hit the links down below. I love you guys so much. Hope you guys have a good one. I'm JB Gunner. This is Crime Time. Peace out.